Sports. It's in the game. EA Sports coverage of the NFL is in Houston, in the Space City at NRG Stadium. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one, as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Houston Texans. And we are underway from NRG Stadium in Houston. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. At their own 23-yard line.
Here we go, check!
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
From the 28, it's second and five.
Ready.
Stroud sets up the play action. Out to his left. That one complete. It's tamped down. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. 27 yards there, a first down.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. They'll go play action here with Stroud. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Heavy set out there on third and one. Pierce will try to pick it up. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got to like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what?
Touchdown, Texans! Nico Collins, 30 yards. And the Texans get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon.
Walking into the stadium, we saw a ton of people donning the jerseys of this rookie quarterback, so you know they love that opening drive, and he throws a touchdown pass.
He gave a little bit of confirmation about what they had hoped, right? Because they thought they had a quarterback. They're thinking they have a quarterback. You do this, they believe they've got a quarterback. Look up, elbowing each other up in the stands. That's our guy.
And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10
at their 25-yard line.
They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Nice effort from Jalen Petrie getting to him behind the line of scrimmage.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Meanwhile, Fields throw here into the hands of Moore. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that's going to bring out the third down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Midfield. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
Here we go.
Second and 5. Here's the first carry for Khalil Herbert. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to throw from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Here we go.
3rd and 4. Herbert once more. And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Bears nothing.
The Bears with the football. We get set to begin quarter number 2. As they've got it with 4th down and 1. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on 4. Inside the 25. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the 4th down attempt and keeping the drive alive? They run it on first with Foreman. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. They'll run here with Herbert. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Second and goal from inside the 5. Foreman. He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. That second down play nets a minus 4.
And now third and goal coming up. The loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder. And they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown, Bears. DJ Moore from 8 yards out. And the Bears are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Had the option to hand that one off or run it himself, but instead, a really easy, quick pass.
I like the way they made a decisive decision and got it right to the receiver. One move later, he's in the end zone.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Play action. Stroud now. And that one going to come up short, low throw. He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
He's got his target. That's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They'll run a draw now with Singletary. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for, a really good change of pace back.
First and 10, it's Stroud. And got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Dalton Schultz, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans have taken the lead. Fairbairn good with the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
To throw is Fields. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Steven Nelson, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Tyreek Stevenson picks it off. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage.
Well done.
Looking to throw on second down. Fields flush to his right. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the first down.
Evident there that he learned his lesson from the last drive. No way he was going to force a throw that time when nothing broke open, kept it, and ended up running for a first down himself.
Here we go.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Herbert powering up the middle. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. So not quite a first and goal just yet as they come up now second and inches. Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Now motion left with Mooney. That is caught. And the Bears are going to be set up with a first and goal as they get the conversion there on third and inches. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. A final shot before the break. Fields. That's Tamora. He's got it. Touchdown, Bears. A great play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bears have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half.
I don't think it's any state secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone. and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you got a brand new ball game. Santos with the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So the late touchdown ties things as they will kick this one away in the final stages of the half. And we'll still have time for one play before the half as this will be fair caught and brought out to the 25.
Come on, come on.
Hey. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Side Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone.
Here we go, Scott.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense? I think he had to unload that one before we ran into. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Fields. And that is incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion, and more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. On the return is Sims. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Texans will take over. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. The ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 42 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. Following the delay, here's second and nine. And now again, The play clock's going to run out on him.
Well, you got to think, Charles, that one's on the quarterback because everybody was up at the line of scrimmage. He just didn't call for the snap in time.
Yeah, I think he needs a little bit better awareness there because you got to know when the clock's in single digits and either snap it or get a timeout called if you have one.
Go, Reed! Go!
Stroud.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Jaquan Brisker.
And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Foreman powering ahead. And they're knocking on the door now. There's a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line.
It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. They run again with Foreman. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field, but his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
On second down, a run with Herbert.
And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4.
You don't see that a ton, do you? A cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball has moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Good play.
Third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Was that the incorrect read or just more an error on the throw by the quarterback?
I lean more towards the latter because it seemed like he was open there, just missed him on the throw.
And a tough one to miss because now you're dealing with a 4th down. Fields is off, and on comes Cairo Santos for the Chicago field goal.
From the left hash, a chip shot here. Santos' kick is up and through, and they take a 17-14 lead.
So they got the turnover, started with great field position, but in the end, the defense able to hold firm, and they only get 3 out of it.
And I like what you said right there, that defense able to hold firm, backed up into the shadow of their own end zone. Goalpost right behind them. They had to make sure they didn't give up the 6, and boy, they came through in a big way. To them, even though they gave up 3, that's a win for their side.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on 1st down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.